Wait, this has to be... Oh. I'd best back up before that happens. I suspect it's because... last time it was... one this close. I made sure that I was attacking the ankles directly, as in using the Ichigatana rather than the longbow. Yes, hit and run. You have the right idea. You just need to keep getting hit to a minimum. Although how... Yes, we saw it, didn't we? The giant axe fades through. That shouldn't work, should it? But then again... that's not how your world works. But in this world, it does. I didn't provoke. Ow! These guardian goats. Doing the flame breath. Or these are more advanced models that have that feature built in. You keep at it, it's almost. I'm amazed that I'm still alive after getting hit like that twice. Not to mention being roasted. And not third. Well, that's one taken care of. And we saw in the distance... the other one is partially damaged due to... the great bow-wielding Guardian Golem sheathing at it, aiming for me. Now, why is it called Friendly Fire? As the fire isn't friendly. Well... it is if missing. Oh yes, and if enough damage is sustained, then that happens. I would rather not risk that. It's out in the open. but there's only one left, and... Yes, this could be a problem. Use the pillars as cover. So that... you can get closer to it without getting hit by it. No, I didn't think that's going to be enough. As you can see, there wasn't enough cover there. That, however, did. Get as close as possible. And then... you know what to do. Well, you could use... power starting Uchikatanas. But... why risk it? Main reason why I forced one of these up close. In that cave was because there wasn't really that much of a turret. Here, on the other hand, what else is here? Away gates. Let's see where this takes me. Ah, I'm right at that tower and it's full of eagles. Well, birds. Well, a mix of eagles and warhawks. Well, if there's a sight of grace here, I don't know where I can go to get more flight pins. Much as the southwest of the Weeping Peninsula is a good place for getting thin animal bones. Now, a shame that there's not something similar for the hefty animal bone variety. At least, none that I'm aware of. Although, to be fair, we haven't had a reason to look for those yet. Being able to make exalted meat is certainly reason enough for that, isn't it? Those are useful. When fighting, aren't they? Certainly, when combined with the flask of wondrous physic when the strength tier is in use. Along with Golden Vow. It would be good to know what those Stormhawk feathers are for. But before that, let's see what's here. Ah, a tower with a closed door. That could be a problem. There's no way of getting in. Ah. I suspect this has something to do with Godric. I might need to come back here later. Let's see, did the Guardian Golems come back here? They didn't come back in that cave, nor did they come back in... Oh, right. Unlike those two, these come back, don't they? Based on what I'm hearing. In that case, we come back here later. Oh yes, remember the upper parts of Stormvale Castle? Well, we didn't fully explore those yet, did we?
We need to do that.
So there's likely to be more for us to find. At least some of it would likely be useful to us. All the better for us to strengthen us as much as we can. Well, strengthen me, anyway, as I'm the one doing the fighting. As we haven't encountered Godric yet. And with Margit, the fell over. Is that tough? Well, Godric is likely to be even worse, especially considering what we've heard about. Right, you know where to go for... Yes, up the sandbags, after you've picked... Oh. Bolts and a smouldering butterfly. Let's hope you have a... larger life expectancy. Yes, time to... Right. Bunny ears. Can we try that without falling to my death? Like a lemming? If it wouldn't be too much of a convenience. Yes. This way. Looks most promising. Let's see where this takes us. Ah yes, the Claw Talisman. A talisman for an assassin. As it increases the effectiveness of jump attacks. Yes. Just what we need. A superhero landing. We know those are the used, don't we? We know what's down there, so we don't need to drop down there. Same applies for dropping down there. We've already taken care of that grafted sign. Which, unlike the ones in the Fringestone Hero's grave, will not come back. Although I did remember seeing something that could be dropped down for. Well, besides dropping down here. Now, this would have been better for assaulting this emplacement, as at least there's no way up here. Oh yes, it would make sense for them to have mushrooms and smoldering butterflies, as that's required to make their fireballs. Ooh. So that's what those feathers are for. They're for making superior arrows. That's something to consider, isn't it? It might make it an idea to do some farming. As the warhawks are much harder to kill than most other birds, aren't they? Far you have the right idea. Playing a distance game. Uh-oh. Now it's gotten much worse. Yes, firebombs are definitely the way with those. Because, as it was proven the first time, it was remarkably effective. As their shields didn't appear to offer that much protection. Well, either that or you exploited a window where the firebombs would be more effective. Whichever the case, they're the best way to do this. A pity that they're not weak enough for them to do the fire dance. As in, when they're set on fire, they dance into their death. Well, clearly, they aren't that smart. Let's see. What do we know about the lands between so far? Well, first we have Limgrave and the Weeping Peninsula. A deceptively life-filled land. Ruled over by a demigod that is apparently big on grafting. Then we have Kyrian, a land ravaged by the Scarlet Rots, where the town of Sorcery is currently full of the dead, as in spirits. As for what's north of here, apparently it looks different from a distance, but up close, it's not that clear, to be honest with you. Once I've done in Stormvale Castle, I promise you, I will look into that. There are some loose ends in Limgrave. The nice cavalry, along with the epigeal of the Weeping Peninsula. I tested all those out. I don't know, I'm not strong enough yet. I need to be for what it is to be coming. As there's far worse than that, crucible monks. Perhaps even worse than this Godric that is somewhere within Stormvale Castle. Just not where I've already been. Right. Time to make some fire pots. Seven. Yes. I could probably use less, but it's best to make sure. Right, here goes! Ah, so it interrupts that. Ah, so it doesn't interrupt it entirely, depending on how good the timing is. And that was far too risky, but at least he's got roots. And if I'm not mistaken, that's enough to level up at least once. Don't know about any more than that. Ah, yes, of course. I remember this. although I didn't go that deep into it. Ah, good. Arrows. You can never have too many of those. Down here is death. Yes, definitely remember what's here. But as for this, I'm not sure how to get through it, as there's no imp to stick the stone sword key in. That's most irritating. There's also no passing through. There's also no... dispelling it by hitting it. Let's check up here to make sure. And... no. We need to figure that out if we want to find out what's there. Unless it's unlocked from the other side. Yes, that's right. Use the runes while they're still there. Yes, more dexterity. Which means slightly more damage. There's also that item that we just saw below that we didn't pick up. Let's go get it. Why do I put up with this? Can you do this without falling every few? Oh, guess it. You'll probably do that more than once. More during this. Can't avoid it if you can help it. How annoying that to be. It certainly is annoying to me, as I'm the one doing the falling! I suppose those smithing stones were worth the detour, as they could be used to improve weapons. Well, if not in the immediate future, then at some point in the future. It depends on the weapon. Another lift. Let's see what's up. So far, nothing fresh. Ah, pots with arms and legs. I wonder if these would be friendly like Iron Fist Alexander. No, they're not. Especially not the big one.